Roman Empire was a complex and diverse society, and the experiences of queer individuals within it varied greatly depending on factors such as social class, gender identity, and geographic location. In ancient Rome, there was not a specific term to refer to homosexuality or homosexuals as a distinct group in the way that we use these terms today. In general, however, being openly queer in the Roman Empire was not accepted, and could lead to persecution, social ostracism, and even death. Throughout the history of ancient Rome, same-sex relationships between men were often considered a serious moral offense and punished by law. For men in ancient Rome, virtus was a defining characteristic of their identity and social status. It was believed that virtus was essential for men to achieve success and respect in Roman society, and men were expected to strive to embody this ideal throughout their lives. Virtus was closely associated with qualities such as courage, self-discipline, and perseverance, all of which were considered crucial for men to succeed in the competitive and often violent world of ancient Rome. Men were expected to be brave in battle, to endure physical and emotional hardship without complaint, and be willing to sacrifice their own interests for the good of their families and the state. Men who demonstrated virtus were highly respected and admired in Roman society. They were often rewarded with honors such as military promotions or political office, and were seen as role models for others to emulate. At the same time, the pressure to embody virtus could also be overwhelming for men in ancient Rome, and the fear of falling short of this ideal could be a source of anxiety and stress. As we have already said, the ancient Romans did not have a concept of sexual orientation in the way that we do today, and they did not view same-sex attraction as a fixed aspect of a person's identity. Instead, they saw sexual desire as a fluid and changeable aspect of human behavior that could be influenced by a variety of factors, such as age, social status, and cultural norms. In general, male-male sexual relationships were more accepted in ancient Rome than female-female relationships. In ancient Rome, the term pathicus was used to refer to a man who played the passive or receptive role in a male-male sexual relationship. The term was often used in a derogatory way to describe men who were seen as weak, effeminate, or morally suspect due to their participation in same-sex relationships. Male-male sexual relationships were generally stigmatized in ancient Rome, particularly those between freeborn Roman citizens. The Roman social order was based on a hierarchical system of gender and age, and same-sex relationships were seen as a violation of this order. The active partner in a male-male sexual relationship was not usually subject to social censure, but the passive partner, who was seen as taking on a feminized role, was often subject to ridicule and ostracism. Same-sex relationships between freeborn Roman citizens were considered socially unacceptable, because they were seen as a violation of the hierarchical social order based on gender and age, and it was common for wealthy men to take teenage boys as lovers despite censure. Boys who were taken as lovers by wealthy Romans were from lower social classes and would have been attracted to the prospect of receiving education, training, and financial support from their patrons. They would have been expected to provide sexual companionship to their patrons in return for their support. The relationship between a boy and his patron would typically begin with the patron taking an interest in the boy's physical beauty and youth. The patron would then take the boy into his home and provide him with education and training in various skills and disciplines, such as music, poetry, and rhetoric. The patron might also provide the boy with clothing, food, and other necessities. In return for his patron's support, the boy would be expected to be sexually available to him. The relationship between the two was often seen as a form of mentorship, in which the older man would serve as a guide and mentor to the younger man. However, it was also a sexual relationship, and the younger partner was expected to be sexually submissive to his patron. The lives of boy lovers of wealthy Romans, who were usually between 12 and 17 years old, were not without risk. The relationship between a patron and his prodigy was often subject to jealousy and competition, both within the patron's household and in wider society. Additionally, the social stigma attached to same-sex relationships in ancient Rome meant that the boy lover could face ostracism and ridicule from his peers and wider society. The lives of the boy lovers of wealthy Romans would have been shaped by a complex mix of social and cultural factors, including the values and beliefs of their patrons, their own individual desires and aspirations, and the attitudes of wider society towards same-sex relationships. It is difficult to provide a definitive answer to how long boy lovers of the rich ancient Romans lived, as their lives would have varied depending on a range of individual factors, such as their social class, health, and access to resources. Usually the relationship between boy lovers and their patrons was relatively short-lived compared to other types of relationships. Homosexual relationships between ancient Roman soldiers or warriors were not uncommon. They were not encouraged, but they were not condemned in the same way as civilian relationships. One of the main sources of evidence for same-sex relationships between Roman soldiers comes from the poetry of the Roman poet Martial, who wrote in the 1st century CE. Martial's poems often celebrate the beauty and desirability of young male soldiers, and he frequently refers to their sexual relationships with other men. In the context of the army, there are several other references to same-sex relationships between soldiers in ancient Roman literature, for example in the poetry of Catullus. Other sources also suggest that same-sex relationships were accepted to some extent in Roman military culture. For example, the Roman writer and philosopher Plutarch wrote about a pair of male lovers who were soldiers in the Theban army in ancient Greece, and his account suggests that same-sex relationships were not considered taboo in the military context. Same-sex relationships between women were viewed even more negatively than those between men. Same-sex relationships between women would have been seen as a deviation from the traditional gender roles of women as wives and mothers, and could have been seen as a threat to the patriarchal structure of Roman society. While there are some references to women who engaged in same-sex relationships in ancient Roman literature, such as the poet Sappho, these references are relatively rare compared to the amount of material that exists on male same-sex relationships. Additionally, many of the references to same-sex relationships between women in ancient Roman literature are presented in a negative light, often as evidence of moral depravity or sexual excess. There are a few examples of ancient Roman women who were rumored to have been punished or killed for engaging in same-sex relationships. One well-known example is the story of the Roman Empress Messalina, who was rumored to have engaged in same-sex relationships and other sexual misconduct during her reign in the 1st century AD. According to some accounts, Messalina and her female lover were publicly executed for their relationship. There are also references in ancient Roman literature to women who were punished for unwomanly behavior or engaging in same-sex relationships. For example, the Roman poet Juvenal wrote about a woman who was executed for turning into a man and engaging in same-sex relationships. Marriage in ancient Rome was a legal and social institution that was based on a heterosexual model with the primary purpose of producing legitimate heirs and maintaining family lineage. Roman law recognized only heterosexual marriages, and there is no evidence of any legal recognition of same-sex unions. Same-sex marriage was not only banned, but it was not even considered a possibility. The Roman legal system did not recognize same-sex relationships in any form, and there were no legal protections or benefits for same-sex couples. While there were certainly examples of same-sex relationships in ancient Rome, they were generally viewed with suspicion and disapproval, and there were often cultural and religious traditions that discouraged or condemned such relationships. The attitude towards same-sex relationships in ancient Rome was largely shaped by the dominant cultural and religious beliefs of the time, which viewed heterosexuality as the norm and homosexuality as deviant or sinful. While there were certainly subcultures and communities that accepted or even celebrated same-sex relationships, they were often marginalized and subject to social and legal persecution. One of the main sources of opposition to homosexuality in ancient Rome came from the Christian Church, which emerged in the later years of the Roman Empire. Early Christian leaders such as St. Augustine and St. John Chrysostom were vocal in their condemnation of same-sex relationships, and their views had a significant impact on later Christian theology and morality. However, it is worth noting that opposition to homosexuality in ancient Rome was not limited to Christian sources. Many Roman writers and intellectuals expressed disapproval of same-sex relationships, including the philosopher Seneca and the poet Juvenal. Roman Emperor Augustus is known to have promoted a conservative morality that emphasized the importance of marriage and family, and his reign saw the introduction of laws aimed at promoting heterosexual relationships and limiting extramarital affairs. While the laws he introduced did not explicitly forbid homosexual relationships, they reflected his emphasis on promoting traditional family structures and values. One of the laws that Augustus introduced was the Lex Iulia de Adulteris Coriscendis, which was aimed at punishing adultery and other sexual offenses. While the law did not specifically address homosexuality, it did impose penalties on individuals who engaged in sexual activities outside of marriage, which could have included same-sex relationships. Overall, the attitudes toward homosexuality in ancient Rome were complex and multifaceted, reflecting the diversity of perspectives and experiences within Roman society. While same-sex relationships themselves were not illegal sexual acts between free adult men, were considered a breach of decorum, and were punishable by social ostracism. Same-sex relationships between men and boys were more accepted but still subject to certain legal restrictions. Women engaging in same-sex relationships were largely invisible in Roman society.